Hi everyone, I'm Cody Holyoke in Kansas City, Kansas at the Strawberry Hill Museum, and it really is a wonderful place where you can learn about all of the history and all of the cultures that combined right on this hill in KCK. Nice enough to show us around is Bernadette. Thank you very much. And she's volunteers here with the museum. In fact, everybody here is volunteer, right?
Everything. We are a nonprofit, all volunteer organizations, but we're very pleased to have you here.
All right. Well, thanks for having us. Tell us about Strawberry Hill, because some people might not know where that name came from, but there's so much history here.
Right. It's a three-part history, actually, and it all centers around the beautiful Queen Anne-style home built in 1887 by a prominent attorney. His family lived there 32 years. Then in 1918, the big flu epidemic hit the city, and so the home was sold and turned into an orphanage. For the next 69 years, almost 3,000 children found their home here. Then in 88, the nuns felt their mission was through, and it was decided to turn the grounds into a museum to help promote and preserve all the various ethnic group that helped settle Kansas City, Kansas here in Wyandotte County.
Oh, wow. And so where does Strawberry Hill get its name?
Well, when the immigrants first came over to work in the meatpacking industry down by the bottoms, by the river, it kept flooding. So eventually they made their way up this huge hill. It was covered with wild strawberries, and thus the name, Strawberry Hill.
That's really neat. And so if you've never been to this, I mean, it's a mansion is what this is. I mean, it's really, really neat. We are in the Hall of Immigrants, and Bernadette, what I think is remarkable about this is that every room in this hall represents a country.
Exactly. That just shows the diversity here in the center of Kansas City, Kansas, and Wyandotte County. And each ethnic group takes care of its own room. They decide what artifacts they want to have on show, and then they just decorate it for the holidays. For Christmas, it's coming up, and they'll be decorating soon.
Yes. Are these mostly Eastern European countries?
There are a lot of those, but we also have Germany, Ireland. So there is just not the Slavic area, but that seems to be the most group represented here.
Interesting. And then Caleb, you just showed it here a second if you want to go back, talking about a hidden gem here. This is not something that you would expect to see here, but it's really almost a shrine to, well, St. John Paul II, Pope John Paul II.
Yes, we have the bed that he slept in the TWA plane he used when he toured the United States. So we were very honored and proud to have this because now he has been canonized a saint, and so that is considered a second-class relic because he had personal contact with it.
And so this was, you said he used this a few times on his trips to...
Three different times in 1987, 1995, and 1999.
Nice. So it's something that you wouldn't expect to see, as we said, but it really is neat. And how did you come across this? You just worked with TWA to store it here?
Well, actually, a parishioner next door worked at TWA, and he suggested that they store the bed here after the Pope's first visit, but it was actually built specifically to fit in an airplane by another man, and it was just thought this was the perfect place for it. This was the Polish Pope. He was the people's Pope. He's right down the hall from the Polish room, so we hope his spirit is happy here. So we just thought it was a very good place because we're so ethnically inclined here that it would be a good place to have it.
Well, I think it makes sense, right? And so tell us about, you said you're a volunteer, everyone here is a volunteer, but the museum thrives on donations.
Exactly. We have several fundraisers through the year, but we really depend on the different donations from the tours. We have a gratitude tree, and so we need a lot of, there's a lot of maintenance that goes with an older building like this. We are 100 years old now, and so we really need to have the donations from the people to upkeep all the stuff here in the museum.
All right. Well, if you'd like to help or if you'd like to come by, you can reserve. You have to have reservations online, right?
Yeah. Well, that's just for some specific activities, but no, we are open every weekend on Saturday and Sunday from noon until 5. We are getting ready to close, though, to decorate for the Christmas season, and then we will reopen November 2nd, and we'll be open through January 5th. So I would invite everyone to come to see all the beautiful Christmas decorations and all the different nationalities and how they decorate their rooms.
Well, Bernadette, thank you very much for showing us around. And for more information, you can go online. Just go to Strawberry Hill Museum. In Kansas City, Kansas, I'm Cody Holyoke, KNBC 9 News.